Welcome to this week's edition of General Hospital. That's the way it seems, anyway. Man, what a year it's been as far as the injury bug is concerned. It has really jumped up and bitten us time after time, and again it happened Saturday with some of our key players. Boy, we're down to skin and bones right now. But you know, when you look at it, maybe what I really need, the kind of doctor, it's not Marcus Welby maybe so much as it is a week in a mental ward. Because, hey, it was not the injuries on Saturday that ultimately made the difference. It was the suicidal tendencies that our offensive football team had in the second half when we had a chance to still win the football game. We go out there in four of our first six possessions, and we shoot ourselves in the foot. We end up with four turnovers in our first six possessions in the second half. Now, against a good Texas Tech football team, you're not going to win playing that kind of football. It's just that simple.
16-7, the Raiders lead. Frogs first and 10 at their own 30. Fumble on the handoff. Ball is loose at the Frog 31 and recovered by Michael Johnson of the Texas Tech Red Raiders. So it's a loss of four, and it sets up 3rd and 9. TCU at the Raider 25-yard line. Rasko half roll left, gets a block, wants to throw. Throwing deep in the end zone, and the ball is intercepted. In the end zone by Roland Mitchell, jumping in front of Reggie Davis. Giles stays at quarterback for TCU, and with a split backfield, a half roll right back to throw. Now he throws a little screen out here to Davis at the 39, and he's in trouble running away from it to the 30, to about the 28-yard line. And this ball's come out again by Davis. The Raiders think they've reclaimed it. Bobby Davis ran it back for what would be only about a 5 or 6 yard gain from scrimmage, if that. And they do have it back. Third down, one toss left. Bradford, Davis making. He fumbles at the 5, and it's recovered by Merv Skurlar. 15 seconds left in the game here in Fort Worth. This is going to be a big win for Texas Tech. TCU first down and 10 at the Raider 35, and Lemire throwing deep for Burnett, and the ball's intercepted.
As a boy, I remember growing up, Dad Wacker always used to say, hey, no matter how dark the clouds, you better always look for the silver lining. You better look for some of the good things that were there. And there were some good things on Saturday. Pat Bradford, a senior running back, finally got really his first big chance. He rushed for 72 yards. He completed a pass for 29 yards. Boy, was I ever happy for that young man. And there were two other players, two receivers, Jared Delaney, Reggie Davis. Boy, did they have a great day. Our quarterbacks, even though they were under tremendous pressure from Texas Tech, they threw the ball well. They completed 17 out of 25 passes. That's not bad, 225 yards. But the guy I can't get over is Reggie Davis. He caught 6 passes for 62 yards. He had 68 yards in kickoff returns, just 3 of them. And I'll tell you what, he is coming on, and he is developing into maybe the best, finest receiver that I think I've ever coached. And the 1-2 punch with he and Delaney right now is really something special. You know, with all the running backs out, we just may have to go to those two guys a little bit more in the future, because they are really something special.
It's 3rd and 17, and Rasko rolling right to throw, has time. Going downfield for Delaney, and the ball is caught at the 6. He's got a man to beat and is forced out of bounds at the 2-yard line. 3rd and 13 at their own 22, split backs. Rasko half roll right to throw. Standing, looking, throwing, and the ball is caught short of the first down by Burnett. Tominey on the right side and Ford on the left, split backs. Rasko play fake back to throw with a block, pump fake, throwing right to the tight end at the 28. Tominey out to the 35 and all the way out to the 43-yard line. Third down and 12 for TCU. Rasko 3 out of 6 throwing the ball today, and here comes number 7. Looking to the left side, dumps it off underneath to a back at the 15, or to Davis, the flex end, and he's carried up around the 21-yard line.
Reggie Davis.
3rd and 8 now from their own 12-yard line, and Rasko back to throw, shovel pass forward to Davis at the 10, cut back 15, struggling at the 17.
Pitch pass goes to number 22.
Wishbone behind Rasko, but the fullback is a wide receiver, Delaney, and Rasko's back to throw, looking left. Underneath to Davis at the 21, upfield to the 30, breaking to the right with a first down across the 40 to the 44-yard line before Michael Johnson can get him. 10 carries for 53 yards and a touchdown, and the Frogs are at the Raider 40. Rasko to throw on first down, underneath to Davis at the 32, upfield. Giles stays at quarterback for TCU. And with a split backfield, a half roll right back to throw. Now he throws a little screen out here to Davis at the 39, and he's in trouble running away from it to the 30, to the, about the 28-yard line. It is second and 13. And Giles rolling right, being chased, throwing on the run. Davis with a catch at the 25. Turns it down at the 21-yard line and wrestled out of bounds.
Reggie Davis with the reception.
Frogs look at second and seven at their own 23-yard line. Now Giles has been the quarterback most of the fourth quarter. And with a half roll right, gets a block from Davis, looking left, dumps it underneath for Davis, slips a tackle upfield to the 25, and wrestled down at the 26 in bounds. Third down for the Frogs. Giles, shovel pass. Higgs, room on the right side of the 40. Upfield to the 45, to midfield, down to the 40-yard line. First down and 10 at the 41-yard line of Texas Tech. Giles spinning left, throwing to Davis underneath and stuffed after a 3-yard gain. Second down and 8, TCU at the Texas Tech 39-yard line. Giles half roll right to throw. There's Davis at the 36. Downfield for a first down and tripped up at around the 27-yard line. 2:05 left in the game as Higgs comes back in, replacing Davis. Second down and 8 at the 25. Giles rolling right with a block from Bradford. Throwing back left. Delaney, touchdown. Right in front of Nixon. Giles executed that beautifully. He rolled to the right, he got a block from Bradford, and as he rolled to the right, he stopped, swiveled, looked left. Delaney had a half step running on James Nixon to the post, and Giles drilled it in for the touchdown. At its own 36-yard line now. Lemire with a toss right to Bradford. Option throw. Bradford throwing deep for Davis. It's caught at the Raider 35, and he falls down there. Halfback option pass from Bradford to...
Didn't let it get any worse.
Jim Wacker sends out his sophomore punter, Chris Becker, who is among the top 15 in the country in punting, and he kicks it away to the exciting little Tyrone Thurman, who is 11th in the country in punt returns, and had the big return against Texas last week. Becker gets this one up into the wind. Thurman drifts to his right, sees it hit at the 5, drifting to the end zone, but killed at the 1-yard line. Great kick coverage by TCU and a 51-yard kick by Becker. It was Tommy Sharp who killed it at the 1. TCU will be forced to punt for the third time. Tyrone Thurman waits at his 20. A great kick by Becker. Mercy, it's back to the 7. Here's Thurman upfield. And tripped up at the 10, still on his feet, and now swarmed at the 11-yard line. Bill Tominey, the first down to get him. We also have a flag. So Becker has to punt, and he has another boomer. This one going to Thurman at his own 19, upfield to the 25, slips a tackle at the 27, still churning and stopped at that point. So we have 12:03 left in the first half with the Frogs leading the Raiders 7-0. That is a tackle for a loss, and it sets up 4th and 6 at the 5, and Becker's kick out of the back of his own end zone is taken at midfield by Thurman and coming left, and looking for a turn upfield, and he can't, and he's stopped for a negative punt return. Tremendous coverage by the man who snapped it, Doug Elms. And they'll have to punt again, and the Raiders will wait for it. Tyrone Thurman drifting back from his 30. Another great kick by Becker. Goes over his head and rolls into the end zone for a touchback. That's a 73-yard kick.